It's great to be here again, and I'm actually going to do something a little bit different. I think Abe did a spectacular job of giving you the overview. I want to drill down into one particular segment, because as Abe pointed out, Israel now is leading not just in the traditional cybersecurity or precision agriculture, but in many new areas such as artificial intelligence. We all know about automotive, but I want to focus right now over the next 10 minutes on an area which we're quite bullish on at OurCrowd, and that's digital health. If you look at what's going on in Israel in terms of digital health, we're literally a world power, and not just, and this is what's so interesting about it, in terms of the technology we're developing, but also in terms of the amount of data that we've aggregated. Because Israel was so early in terms of digitizing our medical health records, literally 20 years, roughly, we now have some of the world's largest databases in terms of both patient health records, as well as, for example, medical imaging. And those of you who know a little bit about artificial intelligence know it's not just the power of the algorithms, but it's the power of the data sets. And that's what's making Israel really punch above its weight, in addition to the fact that digital health is by its nature interdisciplinary, where you need both medical background, software background, often integrating it with IoT. There's no better place in the world than Israel to do that kind of integration. When you look at how many digital health companies there are now in the country, almost 500, okay, which is interesting because you're seeing in the big sectors like automotive, cyber, probably about 600, automotive, also about 500, but there's real critical mass in terms of this. And by the way, the Israeli government is starting, you know, you've seen all these this data before. The Israeli government is starting to focus on digital health, and in fact, the government made available just recently 600 million shekels to further develop digital health, but in particular to create the legal infrastructure so that we can out-license access to many of our data sets and start to turn Israel into the world's laboratory for digital health. This is our fund, Cure, which we launched at OurCrowd. You might know that OurCrowd allows you to invest in individual companies. We have about 160 of those, but we also have now 13 funds, some of which we actually incubate ourselves, such as this fund, Cure, which is a digital health fund. We just are now, you know, closing in on our final closing. It'll be somewhere a little north of $40 million just for digital health itself. And again, we're focusing on health and awareness. When you talk about digital health, you're talking about a very, very broad range of everything from nutrition to remote diagnosis to AI-driven interpretation of medical imaging. So if you look at our portfolio already at Cure, we have some of the leading companies literally in the world already in digital health in this portfolio, and we'll talk about them in a brief second from now. We already saw that slide. Just one shameless bit of promotion about OurCrowd. We've gotten, you know, quite large over the last couple of years. We started 5 years ago. We're now going to pass this year the $1 billion under management, and next year we hope to double again. We're doing this for the power of 25,000 aggregated investors worldwide, and we're looking at a lot of companies. We're actually investing not just in Israel. About 70% of our investments are in Israel and about 30% outside of Israel. Our portfolio is very, very broad and includes, as you see in the upper left-hand quadrant, a lot in the healthcare and digital health area, but also everything from drones to cybersecurity to ag, et cetera. So let's talk about some of these companies that are setting the pace in Israel and digital health. Zebra Medical is about as good as it gets. Was named by Fast Company as one of the top five AI companies in the world, together with Google, IBM, and Baidu. What they're doing is letting AI interpret your medical imaging data, your CT or your MRI. And literally, they're offering this service at $1 a scan together with Google. We just raised a $30 million round together with the participation of Johnson & Johnson and others. You're going to hear a lot about this company, Zebra Medical. CybermdX is the best of cybersecurity for the digital health world. Unfortunately, in 2 or 3 years from now, you are going to hear about people getting a ransom note saying, not that I've taken your data, send me money, or I'm not going to give it back to you, but I've taken control of your pacemaker, insulin pump, et cetera, and you have 30 minutes to live. That is literally the future. And companies like CyberndX are going to help protect us from that horrible possibility. Then there are companies like Intuition Robotics, who are using digital health to essentially provide a robot that gives elder care a whole new name. This company is so potent that Stephen Colbert is already making fun of it. Let's see.
Because seniors love technology. The new ELLI-Q will help the elderly text, FaceTime, and do other online activities, as shown in their promotional video.
ELLI-Q reminds me to take my meds, arranges rides for me. She even reminds me of all my appointments.
Mary, don't forget bridge with the Golden Girls at 1 p.m. Would you like to practice?
No, I don't need to practice.
I didn't catch that. Do you want to play bridge or not?
Oh, fine.
I said it's time for bridge practice. Don't upset me, Mary. It would be a shame if someone mixed up your meds.
You know that we're on to something when Colbert is jumping on you. Here's another extraordinary company that's been around for a while. It's actually almost ready to celebrate its 20th anniversary. The company's called Insightec. And we just participated in the largest ever round for a private company, apropos what Abe was talking about in terms of scale up in a medical company in Israel, $150 million round led by the Koch brothers. And this company, what it's doing is literally off the charts. You just have to see the video to believe it.
This is what Parkinson's disease does to Kimberly Spletter: uncontrolled movements, shaking, and wobbling.
It got to the point where I was having difficulty getting dressed. I have a grandson. I couldn't snap his onesies. I was at a wedding recently and I couldn't dance with my dad. It was sad.
Now, doctors at the University of Maryland Medical Center are experimenting with a brand new treatment, something that's never been done before. It's called MRI-guided ultrasound.
It's been known for a long time that if you make lesions in certain parts of the brain, you can eliminate some of the symptoms.
And that's exactly what this treatment does, except there's no cutting and no surgery. Kimberly underwent this treatment less than a week ago. She says she had to shave her head, but the procedure didn't hurt. The only feeling is intense heat. The results, though, were immediate. She was able to walk.
It was just absolutely the most incredible thing in the world.
And when we met Kimberly this morning, there was even more emotion because she was able to accomplish something else: running, a favorite hobby that she hasn't been able to do for years.
It's turned back the clock for me. You know, I have a new lease on life. I can do things that I want to do. It's a blessing.
It's a blessing. This is, you're going to hear a lot about this company. It's literally Spockian, okay? It's when you see what happens, these people go into the MRI-guided ultrasound, they come out walking again minutes later. It's mind-boggling. This company, Tytocare, is using essentially almost like landing gear kind of technology to give the mother at 2 a.m. the ability to stick something in her child's ear without fear of perforating the eardrum. Literally, that device guides you with a green light until it gets yellow or, God forbid, red, and then transmits an extraordinary image. We invested there together with Ping An, the huge Chinese insurance company, and together with Walgreens. BrainQ has just been accepted as one of the four companies in the world by the Google Medical, essentially digital health incubator. What they do is they simply restore nerve function for severed spinal cords. And it's remarkable stuff. It's using electrical stimulation, but first reading our unique electrical systems that we all have. And you'll be hearing a lot about that company as well. Our company DreamMed has just been FDA approved for the artificial pancreas. This is a closed loop company that is actually replacing the doctor setting your insulin levels using software and AI to do that. If you look at MeMed, I mean, don't get confused, MeMed and DreamMed. MeMed is a brand new investment of ours who is giving you instant diagnosis of whether or not what is affecting you is viral or bacterial. And the biggest investor to date until now has been the U.S. Army, who's very interested in this. MedAware is using big data to prevent prescription errors. Unfortunately, according to data they collected at the Harvard Medical School, 4% of all prescriptions at Harvard are wrong, and a big chunk of them are dangerous. In order to stop that, we need big data analysis that can prevent this, and in particular, solve the opioid epidemic. EIMindA is doing essentially brain health scans so that elderly can have a baseline to see how they're doing as they get older. Scopio Labs is using big data to essentially change the way that pathology is done. If you look at pathology today, it's still analog slides, which we spend hundreds of millions, even billions of dollars worldwide to send rather than digital imaging with microscopes. Site Diagnostics is using optical technology to give you a new, essentially complete blood count, CBC, which is the basic element of most diagnosis in hospitals and in labs. Surgical theater is giving you Israeli flight simulation technology to essentially give the brain surgeon a look before and an ability to simulate what he's going to do before he gets into your brain. Sweetch is a digital vaccine for diabetes. You follow Sweetch, and according to the clinical results delivered at Johns Hopkins, your chances of getting diabetes have just been lowered. And finally, we announced recently a partnership here in the UK with Halma to go work on new activities to create digital health partnerships between Israel and the UK. You're going to be hearing a lot more about digital health. This is a new area for Israel, an extraordinarily important area, not just for Israel, but for the world. And again, congratulations to Leon and to Hugo and to the entire UK-Israel business scene. This is really wonderful. Great to be here. Thank you.